Get that out. Just pull this over. Well, hello, everybody. Welcome to Create Talks. This is where we get incredible, blessed, and highly favored people on sharing their stories of how God's working with them in the presence of God. And I have Alice Gavin from the UK. Welcome, Alice. How are you doing?
Hey, good. Thank you. Yeah, I'm really excited to be here.
I'm excited too. Woohoo! We have had such a wild and crazy journey together. Alice is in a third year program. It's called Mentorship in Create Academy. And we've had quite the journey together. But we love to do shout outs. So let us know where you are from and your name and what you want to learn. We're talking about a collaborative. So we're talking about how can we collaborate together. If you've done anything in a collaborative way with other creatives, let us know as well. But let's begin by what you learned in the first 2 years in Create Academy. What were some of your highlights? What happened in those first 2 years?
Yeah. Wow. I mean, there's so much really. But I think for me, there's two really big highlights. So the first being, about expanding my perspective around community. So, you know, here in the UK in London, we've had a small Kingdom Creative community going for a little bit of time, but there was nothing like joining up with others around the world and even in the UK as well, and hearing from them and just being so encouraged by them, and hearing how the Lord is working in their life and what little seeds he's birthing along the way. And in doing that in community with others, it expands your mind as to what he's doing, right? So that is like really encouraging and has been a massive blessing for me and for many others. And, you know, secondly, more of a personal journey was definitely around the Create to Be Free and just encountering just healing in ways I never thought I needed or I never even knew about. And he just opened up kind of just so much in that course. I really recommend it. It was incredible. And in doing that, you know, I'm a painter, but he blew my mind in terms of other diverse expressions. So, you know, I had paintings that became songs. I had little downloads of songs and songs that then became poems and paintings that then became poems. And, you know, and I saw that with others as well. Like I could see, you know, they might have started off thinking they were writers and then they were trying sketching or they were trying baking, and just so encouraging. So yeah, that was really the highlight. That was really the highlight really for me.
I think it was for so many. I think that we have so limited God's creative power within us and what's needed for a specific reason and in time. And you know, Da Vinci, I mean, he had so many different things that he did in his life. He designed helicopters. He worked as a mathematician. I mean, he did so many different things that really painting was a side thing to him. But every creative discipline kind of opens you up to become greater in the thing that you love as well. So that thing that says like just to specialize in one, I don't think that that's biblical. And I don't see that happening with what happened in Exodus 31 with Bezalel. I mean, they were anointed in all different kinds of ways because that's what was needed. And we see that. And I agree with you, Alice. It was crazy how with the pandemic, that forced us into a different kind of learning style. And with Zoom and stuff, I was able to reach into the UK, reach into like Singapore and all different places, South Africa, and that I wouldn't have. So yeah. It's a delight.
So powerful.
It's a delight to see how Create Academy has expanded, and it's amazing. Let me see if we have any shout outs of people. Let's just see here, your wonderful fans. Woohoo! Oh my gosh, This is so cool. Okay, guys, we have shout outs to Naveed Manas, Steve Dow from Texas, Angie Gump from Malaysia, Susan Exxon, I think we know you, Lindy Jenkins, and more are joining. Guys, please shout out. What do you want to learn about collaborating with other creatives? This is so cool. And Susan was one of your collaborators as well.
Yeah.
So welcome, Susan. So but share about your passion for the arts and what you burn for in life. I'm going to share the dream board too, and then share about the event that happened. So we'll do the dream board first. So I'm going to share my screen, and then this is what Alice created. And she's going to be talking about why she put this all together and what it all means. So go for it.
Yeah, so if you just want to pinch out a little bit more, you'll see there's some images at the top. Anyway, the first image is a ripple. It's like a raindrop falling into the water. And that's just a word that I heard from God, that everything that I would like to do in terms of my personal vision, my personal dream, is to be that ripple, to do small things in faith, knowing that they will have a ripple effect, that our yes is a ripple, that my little yes is a ripple of God's love and God's power. And so everything I want to do is linked to that. So I put that there as a visual reminder. This is something Teresa gets us to do quite a bit, these kind of personal dream boards, which just really useful just to have up as a visual. So yeah, just the next kind of layer is just the heart. I just have a heart to bring healing, Father's heart and Father's love into every situation, no matter what somebody's background is, no matter where they're from, whether they've experienced trauma, or displacement, migration. I have a real heart for different people of different nationalities, different faiths. So I put that picture in of the globe and the flags just to remind me of that. And in particular, I have a heart for adolescents. I just find them so funny, so resilient, so courageous, and they keep me on my toes. So I put that there as an image just to remind me that in particular, at this moment in my life, I feel called to adolescence. And then just moving down, I don't know if you can see the full image, but just pinching out a little bit. I've put the paintbrushes there. I am a painter, and I want to do everything operating out of an overflow of worship. I want to make time every single week to just dedicate a whole day of just painting with him as part of my practice, as part of who I am. And in doing so, I want to remain childlike as well. I want to bring that kind of childlike joy and to release the inner child in others as well. My children have definitely been my biggest teachers when it comes to just accepting God's love and accepting Jesus. They're so pure in doing that. So I've put that there to remind me of that. And then lastly, just in terms of my personal dream, is to do things in community with others. And it's about, you know, leadership development and bringing people together. And I've put these colours around the board so that you can see there's the red, the blue, the yellow and the green. And they're like prophetic reminders for me that the red just signifies his blood, that I couldn't do anything without Jesus' blood. The blue, his refreshment. The yellow, his abundance and the overflow, and the green for the vitality of him and who I am in him. So I put them there as well, and I love the way they link up with the Play-Doh colors as well, which wasn't on purpose, but it just kind of happened. So yeah.
Oh, it's so gorgeous, guys. It's so important to do a dream board like this. It's so important to look at our lives, to see the things that mean so much, and then to have reminders about who we are and why we do what we do. And the art is always going to be a part of that journey for you. And that's part of why God has wired you and what your community is supporting. We have some shout outs too, guys. More people are joining. Angie from Malaysia, Mila from Massachusetts. Oh, Susan has a question. Susan, did you ever feel the exhibition wasn't going to go as planned, and did you have to rethink your approach? Woo! This is so good. That's a great question. So we're going to move into the exhibit. Let's talk a little bit about that question that Susan just shared with us, and then let's do the video. But share about that. You had to rethink?
Yeah. So just to backtrack a little bit, I basically had this exhibition space, and it was going to be a solo show, and I had 15 pieces ready to go, and then I heard the still small voice of the Lord saying it's a collective. And that kind of word ripple was just there as that kind of song that I had in my heart, that your little yes is a ripple, your little yes is a ripple. So I was like, okay, I'm going to put together a paper. Eight Christian artists said yes. And I kind of knew just how quickly people did say yes, and that the venue was already there, that we'd had a huge blessing of provision there already. So I felt the Lord's favor in it. And to your question, Susan, yes, you know, at times bringing, you know, eight Christian creatives together, there were moments I thought, oh gosh, you know, not sure if it's all going to go to plan. But at the end of the day, we knew that the Lord was in it from the beginning with this word that he'd given me, and that everybody had said yes to it. So I felt like even if it wasn't going to be the plan that maybe I had envisaged, I knew that we could, you know, still do something within that remit, and that the Lord would bless it. So yeah, but at times it was definitely moments of, oh, what's gonna happen? Is everyone gonna come together? But yeah, praise God, they did.
And I loved how you brought in, and the video you'll talk about this, but how you brought in the component of prayer, the component of, hey, we start with Jesus, we end with Jesus. You'll hear testimonies from this exhibit, and this was post-pandemic. So share about how you brought together first.
Yeah,
so I don't understand it. And it was in the heart of London. So
that's right, and
it's still going on, right? The exhibit.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, the exhibition is actually still on until the 23rd of November. So if you're UK London based, do check out Marylebone Creative Space. So basically, I forgot what the next question was. What was it? What was the next point you said?
Yeah, talk about like what does it mean post pandemic? What was the reason why people would come to this exhibit?
Totally.
How
so
you
I really
people into that.
Yeah. So I really felt that you know, in the UK at least, I'm sure it's the same, it can resonate with many of us wherever we are. Post pandemic, there's definitely this feeling that people are quite down. You know, they were waiting during lockdown for this amazing post-pandemic moment that didn't really happen. People were putting their hearts and hopes in things that they'd longed for. And then there's this idea that we've got them back, but are they really the things that we really thought would give us all of the joy and the hope that we're looking for? That kind of searching, that meaning in life. You know, in the UK, a lot of people have moved away. A lot of people have relocated, a lot of people working from home, a lot of people are still working from home. And it was just a moment really to kind of get together nine different, very diverse Christian creatives. You know, we had poets, we had spoken word, we had digital artists, we had painters, we had photographers, we had amazing immersive light installations. So it was a real kind of plethora of diversity when it came to creative practice. And it offered just a really unique sense of, hey, this is kind of how we've been reflecting a little bit during this time. And although it feels like we're going from crisis to crisis, at least here in the UK, you know, this is kind of our glimmer. And people were very real. They're very raw. They're very vulnerable. They shared very openly from the heart. And that really helped. At least some of the feedback was, you know, that really encouraged me to be vulnerable, to think in that way, or to be a little bit honest about this, or, you know, so it kind of was a very unfiltered way of sharing how we felt during that time. And I felt that by offering that diversity, it really reflected like the Lord's heart, because if you're just kind of all doing the same kind of thing, it's not embracing the diversity that God has given us, that unique diversity that we're created in his image. So we're going to create differently. And that really came across and was so beautiful to see. And you know, in doing that, when we were organizing the thing, obviously people are very different in terms of that, so there was a few pinch points along the way, but
it was so cool because of the bond of the Create Academy students that they had founded in the last couple of years. So they gathered with Alex
yes.
at this event, and yes. it was cool to
yeah.
see what God can do if we're for one another. I love this collaboration yeah. deal, and how, you know, some people were so brought in by Nathan's light show, and others were drawn in by the poetry or the spoken words or by the art.
Yeah.
And it's like, but each thing spoke to them in a different way. And then those conversations brought a deeper meaning to what they needed. And people got healed. People got touched. Things shifted. So so let's watch the video, you guys.
Let's
see it.
Okay. I have to share screen. Let me see.
So Alice is going to go ahead and believe me, you're going to love this. Any comments, anything you want to say to about this, please let us know.
Okay, so I think I'm sharing my screen.
Yes, you're sharing your screen. It's on.
Okay. I'm just going to go here.
Yep, it's on.
Pinch out a little.
There you go. Yeah, we can hear it.
Yeah?
Yep, that's good. Yeah. These are the artists.
I don't have enough words. I'll never live enough lifetimes to fully know your worth, to know all that you deserve. All of my deceptions, all of my duplicity, now there is no record. You assume the best of me, and this is why I thank the Lord for saving me when I was weak. So I will sing. This is why I thank the Lord for everything, and this is why I thank the Lord. All of my affection, everything I have to give, the sum of my attention, it's measured in the praise I lift. So this is how I thank the Lord for saving me when I was weak. So I will sing. This is how I thank the Lord for everything. This is how I thank the Lord. And this is how I thank the Lord for loving me and keeping me. So I will sing. This is how I thank.
Start to spread, start to interact. And if they turn themselves to look at others, they will start to shine. And then another, and then another. And in time, if they stay turned towards the light, they'll find that impossible barriers start to disappear. They start to transform. They start to become channels for a new expression of light, for a new understanding, where vibrancy and life and experience and even pain become part of the story, but they are redeemed by the light, redeemed through relationship, and can act as another way of celebrating life and the one who gives it.
Go.
Okay. It was incredible. Yay. I enjoyed the speaking. I just felt like in the room, God's presence has come to love.
Amen. Amen.
And then Nathan, when he was explaining this, he was like, I don't know, it must have been a good piece.
Amen.
The way you were talking about it was so like natural. And he wasn't talking about God, but then at the end it's like, oh wow, and it you like realize,
amen.
And this is like life. Wow.
That is true. Amen to that. Amen. Just go for it.
Yeah. So to me,
this
is really amazing. I love this. What I got from it was community. And I felt like God was like, you cannot be by yourself, you know? Because when one person's alone, the light dims, but everyone comes together. And I got healed today. Okay. So that prayed for me and I got healed. So yes.
And what's that thing you're holding in your hand, Joy?
Oh, that is my book.
And what does that mean?
It means, I'll tell you later.
Did you sell it? Did you sell
yes,
it?
I
yeah,
did.
Amen.
My
come
first
on.
One.
Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. Thanks, Joy. Thanks, Joy. All right, Charlotte, over to you.
Hey.
What do you want to give thanks to God for tonight?
I just want to thank God for all of my brothers and sisters here just displaying the glory of the Lord.
Amen.
Through the different facets of
Amen.
How they experience God, through the power and through the transformation and the change. It's just so wonderful. It's like almost all the colors coming together, you
Amen.
Know. Got all the words that our friends spoke, you know, Claire, Angela and Troy, and then even Nathan sharing his like story about the light. And if we stray away too far away from the light and from each other, then we're no longer like that rainbow that God wants us to reflect to the world, and that's his promises, you know. And it's just, yeah, it's just so wonderful. And to see all our friends and family really interact, and, you know, someone said to me, like the picture of one of my main pictures, he's like, I don't really do art, but that one is really drawing me to it. And I was like, oh, praise God, because that's just God. It's just, our art just talks about God, and I love that. And yeah, it's just a fantastic time.
Thank you.
Amen.
Go.
Okay, so this is one that I did earlier, but I decided Nathan could show it. So, no, seriously, it was just the best time. It's a load of artists coming together, friends that I've made from like, oh gosh, I would never have made normally, but we just come together. It's been so much fun. Brilliant testimonies. Loved it.
Amen. Amen.
Ooh, Alice, that was so good.
Praise God.
Wow.
Sorry, dead. There you go.
That was so good. We have some comments too. Again, oh gosh, Audrey Griffiths loved it. Judy Zarenda from New York. Susan Shod, oh my gosh, good point about diversity. Mila, that's amazing that everyone said yes. Oh my gosh. I love this thing that we're talking about. Like Alice, like this is it takes the body of Christ for people to see Jesus. It's like one artist could have done part of it, but the fact that you invited in so many different collaboratives. And what they said and how they communicated. Oh my gosh. What was your highlight? What was your takeaway after doing this event? I think that people need to know.
Yeah, there's so many. I think the biggest thing was offering that platform to those Christian creatives. Like, it just magnified by 8 the amount of points that people could access what, you know, the creative expression through the Lord. So we had like a few testimonies, which I'd love to share. So for one of the artists, she experienced healing on the night, praise God, really, really hurting, and then got prayer and received healing on the night. Another artist said that a dad had come up to them and had said that they really valued the power of poetry and hadn't fully appreciated that as an expressive, you know, medium, and he was going to encourage his daughter more with that. So, you know, that's so beautiful. There was another person who'd come up to one of the artists and said that they were recovering from an injury and wanted to explore God creatively, and that this had given them permission to do that and, you know, go and to, yeah, explore God in that way. There was a few people having a chat about the impact that a life can have on others and God's relationship to us. And I don't think they were Christians, so that was a really interesting chat, just one of the artists listened in on. Another chat that another artist had was around how this I think somebody was saying how they didn't really want to create because they were creating from that kind of performance mindset, and they were always a little bit worried to do that in terms of the inner critic. But that enabled a greater conversation around how we create just for joy, just to be creative in his presence. So, you know, that could have been somebody released just as a result of that. We had another artist who said that they were really reminded of God's love and protection and concern. So praise God. I mean, we also had amazing provision. Like we got a free lunch, believe it or not. The venue literally rocked up with a free lunch, and I just love God's sense of humor, because I was directing people to this sandwich shop we have in the UK called Pret, and actually the venue had a Pret lunch just ready to go for 30 and brought that to us. So, you know, we had another artist who was making her way in and actually had a car crash on the way. And, you know, and it was terrible. I mean, we met the night before, we prayed, but yeah, she had this car crash. And when she actually looked at the car the next day, the bumper had been crushed, but it had completely protected all of the inner part of the car. And she had a guy just come up, rock up and help her. So that was an amazing protection as well. Another artist had actually forgotten and had left the door open as she was leaving the house, and there was apparently somebody in the neighborhood that was going around burglaries on that day, and they didn't get burgled. So it's just amazing kind of, you know, protection. But mainly for me, I think the biggest takeaway was the fact that we were coming together as one, you know, a Christian artist together. I mean, half of us didn't even know each other 2 years ago. So, you know, half of us had met on Create Academy, half of us were local. And the quality of those relationships, when we met for the first time, it's like we knew each other already. It wasn't like the first time, you know, it was like we'd already known each other for a long period of time. So that was really beautiful and really, really encouraging as well. So I think that's the biggest takeaway, is like, who knows, like this could be the start of something wonderful, more collaborations, more opportunities. And, you know, and the creative outreach as well was another personal highlight. We didn't get to do as much of it as we wanted. We only got to go in the park, Regent's Park. But it was amazing. We got to give out little cards, and two of the ladies, you know, received them with some emotion and interest as well. So who knows what that led to as well. So praise God.
Yeah, I love it. I think, I mean, you might be thinking about your neighborhood. You might be thinking about, well, what can I do? I don't know anybody, but you do. I mean, the great thing through Create Academy is there's people from all over the world that are coming together and that are learning. We're going to be going to the UK and blessing I'm so excited, all the Creative Academy students there in February, but that's part of God's design is for us to be family and for us to really celebrate one another. And so instead of saying, well, that could never happen, say, no, it will happen because I'm there and because God is going to give me impact and influence. It's a funny thing how just saying that difference makes all, it changes everything. It's like this game changer when we say, wait, God, if you're in me, then this is my neighborhood. This is my community. This is my territory. So God, open up doors that can really bring influence through other creatives as well. And God will just open up those doors. So I just really want people to know, like, you know, Alice, that sometimes we just put so many different limitations on the power of the one who wants us to go and that he wants us to grow. The other thing that's interesting to me when I do these events, because we're going to do one in Huntington Beach this Saturday and going to the pier. You guys, if you're from Huntington Beach or that area and Orange County, come. But the interesting thing is that you get to know people on a totally different level and you get to celebrate different people's reactions to the different things that are happening. And the great thing that Alice is talking about is when we get together tomorrow and talk to the mentors that were there, we know that what Susan went through and the people that she talked to is different than Nathan and different than Alice. They're so, Claire Angela, it's like there's something about multiple touches and then bam, some door opens up and a person just begins to understand that the love of God or that he's been with them all the time. So it's just crazy. You know, share about what you're doing in third year with me and your desire to transform culture. Kind of talk a little bit about that so people see the broad range of your vision about what you want to see happen.
Yeah, so in third year, we're doing this thing called mentorship. So we're all in different pods. A lot of them cross over. But the one that I'm in is around Create to Be Free, so art and healing through Create to Be Free, and also reaching the marketplace, which is just another word for just going out into your community, like anywhere that's non-church. And basically, I feel like at the moment we're kind of forming and storming, like each other's, you know, kind of bouncing off each other a little bit, but ultimately we all share that same desire to either do Create to Be Free in our church or in any context, and also connect with people in the marketplace. So this is a good example. This exhibition is a good example of connecting it was a church, but it could easily have been a non-church context, could easily have been a coffee shop or a gallery or another space. And just connecting, like in London, there's a massive art scene. It's really big. And, you know, when you come in and you see something like, you know, the response to the immersive light installation that Nathan did, you can see that immediately in a bigger art setting, in a bigger venue. Same with the poetry, you know, and, you know, people were so hungry to hear people's hearts in that way and the vulnerability. So it's just now kind of thinking through, well, okay, God, well, what's next then? Where do you want that to go next? So who knows where that could be? So I guess a little bit of dreaming now with the Lord as to what that looks like next.
I mean, I think that's all part of it. It's like people in culture are hungry to be known. They're hungry to understand their story and understand where they fit in that story. And that's what you're creating. And it's just so incredible just to see the hunger and the power behind it. If you could say anything to the creatives that are listening right now, what would you say, Alice?
I would say, your yes is a ripple. So just remembering that ripple image, you know, you might be thinking, I don't know what I have to offer. Could I offer this? I don't know. But that little yes, even that little micro yes, is a ripple effect. And that ripple effect, just as you see in that image, that concentric circle just goes out and out and out and out and out and out. So never forget the power of your little yes. That would be, the biggest thing.
I love that. If you are listening now and you're getting hungry, I mean, when we hear testimonies like this and we see them, you got to get hungry, because it's not that we don't have Jesus, but that we haven't approached people in a way that they can understand who he is in their story or where he is. And the power of what's happening right now is we just have this wonderful exhibit in the heart of London that's causing people to find out where that ripple effect, where they're starting, what they're doing. And as Alice starts to lead this, I just want to encourage you to not hold back. You know, get involved in Create Academy, get involved in your church, get involved in your community. Don't hold back, but let God come. I mean, we have this Ignite conference coming up, and it's going to go viral in a couple of days. That's January 20th. But just whatever you need, God's just going to open up, and he's going to pour out his presence upon you as Alice prays. So Alice, go for it. Let's just let the presence of God come.
Yeah. Thank you, Holy Spirit, that you're with us now. Just pray, we just take a moment just to breathe you in. Thank you that you're with us. Thank you that you love each one of us listening, that you called us by name. Thank you that you've placed your creative seed in each one of us, and that that's from you. And I thank you that by stewarding that little seed, by giving it the right nutrients and water and support system that it needs to grow, that by saying yes to that, we'll create a ripple effect that will go out and that will reflect your heart to people who are really searching for you, Father. So thank you, Lord. And I just pray right now that those little seeds will grow and will flourish in your name. Thank you, Father. I just pray for anyone.
I thank you for Alice's yes. I thank you for the journey that started when she first started to paint when she was small, God, the things that she could start to see and the dream in her heart. I thank you, Father, for how you have given her an access points and, Father, ways that she can identify in culture healing through creative ways and the story of others being interwoven in yours. And God, we just pray that this would start a movement of creatives collaborating together without fear or failure and growing things in their community, growing things where they live that will just begin to soak into the culture what honor, generosity, the prophetic, what healing, what your nature truly is, God. We just thank you for their yes today, and thank you for Alice's, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hey, Alice, amen. Thank you for joining, guys. If you have people in your lives that need this, please share this with them. Again, if you'd love to join Create Academy, there's a special discount. Just go to teresadedmon.com and put in the CA50 off to get 50% off of the first month's membership, and you are going to love it. So again, Alice, thank you again for joining. Woohoo!
Thank you.
Bless you so much, and I'll see you
soon. Thanks. All right.